The Artist is an examination of the culture of American movies during the shift between the origins of classic Hollywood style, the silent period, and Hollywood's golden age. The origins of classic Hollywood style, the silent period, are defined by silent black and white films with cartoonishly expressive faces and grandiose movements. Another important aspect of this era is the studio system itself, a mode of production that standardized the way movies were produced. Meanwhile, Hollywood's golden age is characterized by the emergence of dialogue, music, and other diegetic and non-diegetic sounds within the film itself. The studio system was preserved and remains a force to be reckoned with to this day. This film is set in the late years of the silent era and the transition to the early ones of talkies. Michael Hazanavicius, when asked about creating a mostly silent film, said, "I met a lot of directors, and most of them have that fantasy to make a silent movie because, for directors, it's the purest way to tell a story. It's about creating images that tell a story, and you don't need dialogue for that." One of his inspirations was probably Singin' in the Rain, a classic about a silent actress whose squeaky voice didn't work in talkies, and about a perky little unknown actress who made it big because of hers. The film itself and its actual production sides more with silent films, as there is virtually no dialogue or diegetic sound throughout the movie. However, this movie does have a fantastic score in homage to the classic silent era soundtracks. In one scene, jarringly loud and pronounced diegetic noises are the overture to Valentine's apocalyptic nightmare, playing out his fear of being the only one left unable to speak in a world full of sound. This cinematic segment highlights Valentine's feeling of inadequacy in the face of the rising talkies. At the end of The Artist, the movie flips to sound, and the noise of the room is extremely deafening to the audience, who's used to hearing only the classic silent soundtrack in the background. And then there is dialogue. The first dialogue is just production crew noises, but then George Valentine's one and only line comes, and much of this movie's plot becomes explained. He says, "with pleasure," but it sounds more like "with plaisir," due to Valentine's thick French accent. Now the audience realizes why he was so averse to any kind of talkie. He didn't have the voice. Many star actors during this time period were actually foreigners, as they would work for less money. When dialogue became pivotal to movie productions, these actors suddenly were not important. Many had their careers die alongside the silent film industry. However, there were some stars that were born out of this new necessity for attractive voices paired with attractive faces. Just like Pepe Miller, Joan Crawford and John Barrymore handled these transitions fluidly and well. Overall, The Artist handles the transition to talkies very eloquently. The stylized way it creates a put-together and thoughtful love letter to film history and to American culture itself is truly refreshing. While younger audiences may shake their heads in disgust at a black-and-white silent film, they don't know what they're missing. The Artist is a fantastic movie that employs the styles of classic cinema to depict this pivotal moment in history and craft a beautiful story alongside it.